Sashimwe.
And praise Jesus.
Ndabasuhuje mu izina ry'umwami wacu Yesu Kristo.
I greet you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Kandi mbifuriza n'icyumweru cyiza.
And I take this opportunity to wish you a nice Sunday.
Uyu munsi tugiye kureba kuri Bible study.
So today you're going to focus on the Bible study.
Aho tuza kureba ubukristo ndetse n'igisirikare.
Well, we'll be looking at Christianity and the army.
Cyangwa se umukristo n'umurimo w'igisirikare.
Christianity and serving in the army.
Kugira ngo nabyo turebe icyo ijambo ry'Imana ribivugaho.
So that we can look at what the word of God says about it.
Buriya Imana yacu igira amazina menshi.
Our God has many names.
Ariko rimwe mu izina Imana yitwa.
One of the names of God.
Nuko yitwa Uwiteka Nyiringabo.
He's called the Lord of hosts.
Cyangwa se Uhoraho Imana Nyiringabo.
The Lord of hosts.
Ibyo bifite icyo bivuze.
So it has a meaning.
Kubera ko ni Imana ishoboye.
Because he is the mighty God.
Ariko ni Imana ikomeye irwana kandi igatsinda.
And he's a mighty warrior and who overcomes in battles.
Mu gitabo cyo kuva ku murongo igice cya 15 umurongo wa 3.
In Exodus 15 verse 3.
Bibiliya yita Imana intwari mu ntambara.
So the Bible calls God a mighty warrior.
Impamvu yabyo nta yindi.
There is no other reason.
No kubera ko Imana yacu irashoboye.
It's because our God is able.
Nta cyayinesha.
He's almighty.
Nta cyayikoma mu nkokora.
There is nothing that can interfere with our God.
Na Satani ubigerageza.
And even the devil who tries to do so.
Imana yacu iramunesha kandi yaranamunesheje.
Our God overcomes him and he even did it before.
Ibyo rero bikavuga ngo naho dukomoka.
So which means that even our source.
Urugamba rurahari.
There is a battle.
Igisirikare kirahari.
So there is an army.
Ngiye kuvuga iryo zina mu buryo busanzwe bw'ikirimi cy'uyu munsi.
So if I can use nowadays language.
Navuga ngo Uwiteka Imana nyiri ingabo.
I can say that the Lord of hosts.
Navuga ngo Uwiteka Imana nyiri igisirikare cyangwa nyiri abasirikare.
So I can say God the owner of the armies and soldiers.
Kubera ko afite ingabo nyinshi.
Because he has so many soldiers.
Kandi niringire ko nawe uri muri imwe muri iyo ngabo.
And I believe that you are one of those soldiers.
Akenshi rero iyo dutekereza ku gisirikare.
So often when we talk about the army.
Hari ibibazo byinshi abantu baba bafite mu mutwe.
Many people have different questions.
Icya mbere ese Imana ibivuga wiki?
First of all, what does God say about it?
Ese Imana irabyemera?
Does God accept it?
Ese bigeze ku rugamba mu Kristo nawe burya yafata imbunda karasa kandi umuntu agapfa?
So when it is time of war, can a Christian hold a gun and shoot and kill a person?
Ibyo ni bimwe mu bibazo tuza kugerageza gusubiza muri iyi Bible study.
So these are the questions that we'll attempt to answer in this Bible
iyo
study.
Iyo turebye mu ijambo ry'Imana.
So if we look into the word of God.
Mu gitabo cy'Itangiriro igice cya 14.
In the book of Genesis chapter 14.
Uhereye ku murongo wa 13 ukagera 24.
Starting from 13 to 24.
Tubonamo inkuru y'umugabo witwa Abraham.
We see the story of a man called Abraham.
Wahamagawe n'Imana mu gice cya 12.
Who was called by God in chapter 12.
Hanyuma yarangiza ikamubwira ko izamuhindura ubwoko bukomeye.
And the God told him that he's going to turn him into a mighty nation.
Inamubwira ko azajya aho izamwereka.
And God, in addition to that, he requested him to go where he's going to
lead. Ariko Abraham ntiyagiye ngo avuge ngo buri Imana izahanyereka gusa, ntategure ko bishoboka ko ajya mu rugamba.
So now Abraham did not just take the promise as it is without expecting to face wars.
Ahubwo Bibiliya iratubwira ngo Abraham yatoje abantu bagera kuri 318 bavukiye mu rugo rwe ibijyanye no kurwana.
Actually he trained around 318 people on how to fight. People were born in his family.
Abigisha uburyo bakwiye kurwana.
So he trained them how to fight.
Kandi igitangaje nuko hari umunsi byabaye ngombwa ko barwana.
And the amazing thing, one day it was necessary sorry for them to fight.
Mwishwa we witwa Loti bari bamufashe mpiri.
So and his relative Lot, when he was besieged.
Anyuma barangije baranamutwara bunyage.
So he was taken into captivity.
Bamujyana n'abandi batandukanye bo muri icyo gice aho yaratuye Sodomu.
And he was taken with other people who lived in that area of Sodom where he lived.
Abimenye ahagurukana n'ingabo bajya kubongera kubagarura.
So now when he got to know that, he arose with his army to go and bring them back.
Iyo somye ayo magambo yo mu itangiriro igice cya 14 umurongo wa 13 kugera 24.
Now if you read that passage in Genesis 14 starting from verse 13 to 24,
Abraham agirana ikiganiro n'uwo bita ngo ni umwami w'Isarehe witwa Melchisedeki.
You see Abraham having a conversation with the king of Salem called Melchisedek.
Ese nyuma akagirana ikiganiro n'umwami w'i Sodom.
And afterward he had a conversation with the king of Sodom.
Nshaka ko tubona mwaho ngaho.
So what I want us to get from this,
nubwo Abraham yagiye akarwana arwanishije ingabo ze,
even though Abraham fight using his soldiers,
ariko yamenye ko ari Imana nyiringabo imufashije gutsinda urwo rugamba.
So he got to know that it is the Lord of hosts who enabled him to overcome in that battle.
Nicyo cyatumye yanga kugira andi maturo yakira.
That is why he refused to receive other offerings, especially those coming from the king of Sodom. So God was with him in that battle. So that shows us that the army
mubyagiye bibaho mu mateka ndetse y'ijambo ry'Imana no ku bantu b'Imana.
It is existed in the history of God and his people.
Dutekereje ku zindi nkuru tubona mu isezerano rya kera.
Now if you look at other stories that we find in the Old Testament,
igitabo cya Yosua cyose,
so the entire book of Joshua,
ni igitabo kitwereka Imana itoza Abisiraheli kurwana, irbafasha kurwana kandi bahagutsinda bagafata igihugu cy'isezerano.
It is a book that shows us God training Israelite how to fight and also even leading them in the battle to overcome.
Urebye abami bakurikiyeho nyuma bose,
so if you look at the kings that came afterwards,
usanga buri mwami wese yaragiye agira igihe cyo kurwana intambara usibye abami bake Imana yahaye amahoro impande zose.
Most of the kings had time to go through battles except a few kings that were spared from.
Hanyuma mu bami ba kabiri igice cya 5 umurongo wa 17 kugera 19.
Now in 2 Kings chapter 5 from 17 to 19,
tubona urundi rugero rw'umusirikare,
we see another example of a soldier,
ndetse ukomeye cyane,
a mighty one,
waje kumenya Imana,
who got to know God,
kandi akagira umutima wo kuyubaha,
and he had a reverence for the Lord.
N'umusirikare w'umunyamahanga w'Abasiriya witwaga Naaman.
He's a soldier called Naaman who is a Syrian.
Yari afite ibibembe.
He was a leper.
Umwe mu banyage yari yaratwaye aza kumubwira ati nyamara muri Isirayeli hari Imana yakiza databuja.
One of the captive people that they had taken, she told him that there is God who can heal the master.
Ajayo umwami abanza kugira ubwoba.
So he went there though he was scared initially.
Hanyuma amwohereza ku muhanu, umuhanuzi aravuga ati munyoherereze mukize.
Now he was sent to the prophet and he said, please let him come to me so that I can heal him.
Yo guru sinshaka kwitinda ariko yaramubwiye ngo agende yoge muri Yorodani inshuro zirindwi aravamo yakize.
So I don't want to dwell much on that story, but he was requested to go and dip himself 7 times in the pool and then he was healed.
Initially,
he refused, but then he accepted.
Ariko amaze kubyemera abonye akize.
Now, after accepting that and realizing that he was
agaruka ku muhanuzi ashimira Imana.
So he came back to the prophet in order to thank God.
Abwira umuhanuzi ati ndashaka kuguha amaturo. Umuhanuzi arayanga.
He told the prophet, I want to give you the offerings, but the prophet refused them.
Ariko ibyo ntibyatuma acika intege muri kwa kwizera Imana yabonye muri Isirayeli.
Though he was not discouraged,
avuga amagambo akomeye
in Israel and he said important words.
Mumbabarire mumpe igitaka cya hano.
He said, please give me some soil.
Ariko ikindi nanone ngiye gukora ni iki ngiki.
And something else that I'm going to do. I will not worship any other god.
Ariko hejuru yo kutagira indi mana ndamye.
And on top of not worshiping any other
ngo,
god, I'm going to ask God this.
Ije igingirire mu windeba n'amaso y'impuwe mu gihe njyanye na data buja gusenga Imana senga.
May he have mercy upon me when I go with my master when he's going to pray to worship his idol.
Nije wafata ukuboko nije abanyiyegamijeho.
Because he leans on me when he's going to worship his idol.
Yunamye, nanje ndunama.
And when he leans, I have also to bow down.
Njewi mana senga, ni mana ya Israel.
But the God I pray to is the God of Israel.
Uyu musirikare rero,
now this soldier,
atwereka ko burya n'abasirikare bamenye Imana.
So he shows us that even soldiers get to know God and also honor him.
Reka nivugire n'ikintu ntaza kukibagirwa.
I want also to say this before I forget.
kubera discipline.
Now, because of discipline,
n'umuco utozwa abasirikare.
And also the culture that is given to the soldiers.
Iyo bakijijwe abakristo beza.
When they are saved, they become good Christians. Most of them.
Iyo bakijijwe.
When they are saved,
ntabwo bajyamo igice.
They don't do it halfway. The same way they commit themselves into the army and commit themselves fully. The same way they commit themselves fully into
Christianity.
When we as civilians sometimes we drag our feet. Because you can say we won that battle, now what about this? So the same attitude
you see it in Naaman,
because he believed God of
Israel,
and he had boldness more than others. There are also other soldiers who obeyed God. David is among them. Before becoming a king, he was a shepherd, and he also became a soldier, and he was a soldier who honored God. The amazing thing about David, in being a soldier, he did not trust in his own strength. He always relied on God of Israel. I did not give you that scripture. But if you read in 2 Samuel chapter 5, they show us the story of David fighting against the Philistines. They attacked him 2 times, because he was overcoming them easily. But he continued to lean on God. And then he inquired first from God, should I attack them? Am I going to be with him? And then God told him, go and attack them. Now when he returned from that battle, when they were defeated, now they attacked him again. So when they were he was attacked for the second time, he did not say, let me do it like the first time, but he inquired again from God. So he leaned on God again, and he said, Lord, should I attack them again? Now, God told them, change now the strategy of attacking them. Don't attack them this way. Now you need to ambush them and then wait. Now, when you're going to hear a shout, arise because I'll have given them to you. Though he was a mighty soldier, he continued to rely upon God. Now, if we look in the New Testament, what does the Bible talk about Christianity and army? I want us to read in Luke chapter 3:14. So it is a conversation between John the Baptist he had with different people when they found him baptizing people at Jordan. There were also soldiers, and this is the conversation they had. Luke chapter 3:14. Likewise, the soldiers asked him, saying, and what shall we do?
Arabasubiza ati, ntimukagire umuntu muhongesha cyangwa mumurege ibinyoma kandi ibihembo byanyu bibanyure.
So he said to them, do not intimidate anyone or accuse falsely, and be content with your wages. Now he told them 2 things in this passage. So first of all, he told them, you have authority, you have power and strength. So you should not use them falsely. You should not use the power you have as soldiers, because people fear you. Just because you are carrying armor, and then request someone to give you something that you are not supposed to
receive.
Or accuse that person falsely just to show that you have power over them. So this is the first thing. So don't use your power and use it in a wrong way. Now, the second thing that he said, You should be content with your wages.
Mbitekereza kuri aya magambo.
So as I reflect on these words,
nasanze harimo ibintu byinshi muri iki kintu cy'akabiri.
I realize there are so many things in this last part.
Bimwe mu byagiye bigira ingaruka mu makudeta menshi yagiye aba muri Afrika.
So some of the repercussions of coup d'etats that had in place in Africa, it's because no one preached to the soldiers the same scripture to be satisfied with their wages or salaries. Because soldiers and teachers are among people who don't have good salaries, though they have a difficult job. And this is not for this period. And it is not even a particularity of Rwanda. It is something that is normal. So what God is expecting from them, don't use in the wrong way the authority entrusted to you, and also be satisfied with your wages. So these are some of the things that are explicit that the Bible expressed from the soldiers. So something else that shows that the army is on the heart of God, and that the army has a great importance in the ministry of God,
w'amahame y'ubwami bw'Imana ari faringa cyangwa se yishingikiriza atanga ingero z'igisirikare.
Is about the principles of the kingdom of God that are based on the army.
Hari ibintu byinshi Yesu ndetse na Paulo n'abandi bagiye bavuga,
things that Jesus and Paul and even others that say often,
buri gihe baragaruka ku gisirikare barakoresha ingero z'igisirikare.
And you guys, they keep on mentioning examples of
byinshi, ariko reka mvuge bimwe muri byo.
So we can say a lot, but I want to mention a few.
Timoteo wa kabiri igice cya kabiri umurongo wa kane.
In 2 Timothy chapter 2 from verse 4.
Haravuga ngo nta waba umusirikare kandi ngo yishyire mu by'ubugingo ngo abakinejeje uwamwandikiye ubusirikare.
So it says you cannot be a soldier and entangle yourself in the civilian affairs and continue to be faithful for the one who appointed you.
Ibyo bikwereka agaciro k'igisirikare.
So which shows the importance of the army.
Kubera ko Bibiliya iri kugereranya kuba mu bwami bw'Imana,
because the Bible compares being in the kingdom of God, like being part of the army.
Iyo ubaye mu gisirikare,
when you are part of the army,
ugomba kubaho nk'uko amategeko n'amabwiriza y'igisirikare bivuga.
You are supposed to live according to the terms and rules.
Iyo utangiye kubivanga ugatangira kugenda gisivile,
now when you start mixing things and living like a civilian,
uwakwandikiye ubwo busirikare,
you cannot please the one who assigned you to be a soldier.
Abefeso gatandatu icumi kugera kuri makumyabiri.
Now Ephesians chapter 6 from verse 10
avuga mu bintu byinshi ntabwo byose nza kubivugaho.
There are so many things that
ariko igikubiye muri ibyo byanditswe ni iki?
So the core part of this
haravuga
passage,
ngo mutware intwaro zose z'Imana.
It says take all the armor of God.
Bivuga ngo mwibuke ko mukiri mu gisirikare.
So in other words, remember that you are still in the army.
Igisirikare turimo nk'abakirisitu.
And the army that we are in as Christians.
Ni igisirikare batajya basinya amasezerano yo guhagarika imirwano.
So it is army where there is no ceasefire.
Ni igisirikare batajya bademobilize.
And you cannot resign from that.
Bibiliya rero ikavuga ngo niba uri umukirisito,
so the Bible says now if you are Christian,
uri mu ntambara,
remember that you are on a battle.
Niba uri mu ntambara rero,
now if you are in that battle,
twara intwaro zose z'Imana.
Carry all the armor of God.
Twara intwaro zose z'Imana.
Carry all the weapons of God.
Kuko twara intwaro zose z'Imana.
Because if you do not carry all the weapons of God,
ibyo Imana ishaka ko ukora.
So you are not be doing what God is expecting.
Muri Timoteo wa kabiri igice cya kane umurongo wa karindwi.
Now in 2 Timothy chapter 4 verse 7,
ndetse na Timoteo wa mbere gatandatu cumi na kabiri,
and 1 Timothy chapter 6 verse 12,
avuga ibyo kurwana intambara nziza.
They talk about the how to fight a good
igisirikare kiri ku mutima w'Imana.
Because army is something that is in the heart of God.
Nange n'izindi ngero zikwereka ko igisirikare kiri ku mutima w'Imana.
I want also to give other examples.
Umunyamahanga wa mbere wuzuye umwuka wera.
The first Gentile that was filled with the Holy Spirit.
Utaru umuyuda cyangwa se ngo umunyasamariya ufite aho ahuriye n'abayuda.
Who was not a Jew, a Samaritan who has a relationship with the Jews.
Yari umusirikare witwa Koronelio.
He was a soldier called Cornelius.
Mubyakozwe n'intumwa igice cya 10.
In Acts chapter 10,
ngo yubahaga Imana,
he feared the Lord,
ngo akajya senga Imana,
and he used to pray to God,
agatanga amaturo,
and he would give the offerings,
agafasha abantu,
and he would help people,
nubwo ari umusirikare,
though he was a soldier.
Kugeza ubwo Imana yavuze ngo,
until when God said,
marayika wanjye agenda avugane nawe,
let me send my angel to go and
marayika
talk to him.
Araza aramubwira ngo,
so the angel came and told
Cornelio
him,
we.
And said, Cornelius, your prayers and offerings have been heard before God. A prayer of a soldier. I want to add this. Now, this soldier, he was a Roman soldier. And actually, now those Romans were giving a hard time to Israelites. But it did not prevent him from honoring God. And even God from drawing closer to him. And now he sent a man called Peter, who was at Joppa, and also Simon the Tanner, to go and God said, I'll tell you what you're going to tell him so that he can
receive.
So it's a long story, I don't want to dwell much on it. But you can see that the first Gentile who was filled with the Holy Spirit was a soldier.
Undi musirikare nawe yakoze agashya.
So now there's a soldier who did something
agira kwizera kwatunguye umugabo witwa Yesu Kristo.
And he had faith that amazed the man called Jesus.
Kuri Yesu aramubwira ati umugaragu wanjye ararwaye.
So he came to Jesus and he
kandi
said, one of my subordinates is sick and you have power to heal.
Yesu aramubwira ati reka nzenze kumukiza.
So now Jesus said, I'll come to
ndaramubwira ati oya ntabwo binkwiriye kuzi wanjye.
But he said, it is not worthy that you come to my home. I'm a soldier.
Umunyamahanga.
I'm a Gentile.
Ariko ntabwo gukwiriye ko wirirwa uzi wanjye.
But you are not worthy to come to my home. And he said, how
nange mu gisirikare mbamo ntanga amabwiriza.
And he said, I'm part of the army and I give instructions.
Ntanze arubahirizwa.
And the instructions that I give
now uko nakubonye.
Now the way I saw
ufite ubutware.
You have authority.
Ibwiriza watanga ryakubahiriza.
So the instruction you would give it will be
umugaragu wanjye arakira.
Just command and my servant it will be
Bibiliya iratubwira mu byanditswe mufite hariya muri Matayo.
So in the scriptures you have in Matthew and Luke.
Haravuga ngo Yesu ngo abwira abantu aravuga ngo sinigeze mbona no kwizera kumeze gutya mu Bisirayeli.
Now Jesus said, I've never seen such an amazing thing.
Benshi bazaturuka kure baze batangire kurya ibyo mu bwami abo mu bwami baraho bakanuye.
Said many will come far away and come and eat things in the kingdom when those the kingdom belong to and are just there. Which shows us that
igisirikare
the army
ntabwo ari ikintu Imana ivuga ngo ya iki ni ikintu kibi.
The God does not say that it is something bad.
Kiri ku mutima wayo birenze nuko twe tubyibwira.
Because God cares about it more than we can think.
Kwigira muri ibi bintu byose maze kuvuga.
So what can we learn in all these things that I've just mentioned?
Chambere nuko umurimo wa gisirikare ari umuhamagaro nk'indi yose.
So first of all, serving in the army is a calling like any other calling.
Umurimo wa gisirikare ni umuhamagaro nk'indi yose.
Serving in the army is a calling like others.
Niba Imana ibiguhamagarira,
so if God is calling you to be part of the army,
winabitekerezaho kabiri.
Don't even think twice about this. Go and be a soldier who is a good one. The same way God can call you to be a pastor. The same way God can call you to be a businessman. The same way God may call you to be a soldier. Because we don't see even a single place where even those who are soldiers were requested to resign. Actually, we see them in their army, God working with them to do mighty things.
Ingorane abantu bakunze kwibazaho.
Now the challenges that
no kwibaza ngo nonese ninja mu gisirikare none buriya tukajya ku rugamba.
A person when they say if I go in the army and then we go to a battle.
Kimwe n'indi mirimo yose.
Like other you know works or ministries.
Igisirikare kigira ingorane zacyo.
So the army has its own challenges. So you should not think that being a pastor it doesn't have challenges. Or think that doing business there are no challenges related to
that.
Now the big question when it comes
to
the time of going to a war, am I going to hold a gun as a Christian and shoot at the enemy?
Bibahora?
Or am I going just to shoot rubber bullets?
Oh yeah.
No.
Ahubwo niba uri umusirikare.
Actually, if you are a soldier.
Dukurikije ibyo tubona muri Bibiliya.
According to what we see in the Bible.
Rwose nawe uzagira uruhare mu kurwana.
You are supposed to contribute in fighting.
Mu kuba wakwica umwanzi.
And you can even kill the enemy.
Wenda ibi ngibi nshobora kubivuga gutya mukibaza muti ibi bimeze bite.
So when I say this, you may ask yourself how.
Iyo ugiye mu ijambo ry'Imana.
So if you look at the word of God.
Ukareba abantu Imana yagiye ifasha kunesha no kurwana.
And you see people that God helped to overcome.
Usanga nibabwira ngo nimugera ku rugamba rero ntimuze kurasa.
So you don't see God tell them when you are in a battle, don't shoot.
Ndetse hari nawe yabwiye ngo mwebwe ndabatumye bose murangize.
Actually, in some instances God said go and kill everyone.
Mubice bose bose murangize.
Kill everyone.
Ushatse kubyumva wasoma inkuru za Sauli.
So if you want to understand this, you can read
muri Samueli wa mbere igice cya 15.
In 1 Samuel chapter 15.
Yatumye Sauli ku rugamba.
So he sent Saul on a battle. And he said, go and destroy all the Amalekites. Because of the things they had done for Israel.
Sauli azana ibintu byo kuba umujyama cyane no kushaka kumenya ubwenge burenze ubw'Imana no kugira impuhwe zirenze iz'Imana.
Now Saul tried to be more merciful and to use his own wisdom and the one of God. So some of the things that made him to be moved from his throne is because he did not destroy the Amalekites as he was instructed by God. So it shows that even in a battle when it is necessary, it is important for a soldier to do his contribution and shoot at the enemy. But there is something else that the Bible says. Now those who have been besieged, they should not be killed. So that is in 2 Kings. If you read chapter 6 from verse 20 to 23. So it means that those who are taken captive in the war, they should be released. So the Syrian king was fighting against the king of Israel. Now Elisha will tell them where they had ambushed them. Now the king sent soldiers to come and seize Elisha, so and he prayed and they were blinded. Now he took them to Samaria before the king. Now he said, Lord, let them recover their sight so that they can get to know that I have reached Israel. So when the king of Israel said, when he looked at them, he said, I'm going to kill them. Now Elisha said, don't. If you had planted them, do you think it is necessary to kill them? Now he said, now these ones have been brought by God. Are you going to kill them? Now just feed them and release them so that they can go to their master and tell them that they did a good
thing.
So it is possible to have mercy for those who have been
seized.
Now others may say in Matthew it says if they slap you on one cheek, give another one, how are you going to kill people?
The alternative.
Now you need to ask yourself the alternative.
Uri ku rugamba.
Now when you are in a war,
umwanzi ari kurasa.
Now the enemy is shooting. And then you are not shooting back. What will happen? Not only you are putting your life in danger. Remember there are also other people that you need to protect. There is also a nation that you are supposed to protect behind you. Now, not protecting those people behind you. Now their blood will be on your hands. So you need to decide which blood
you
need. Is it the blood of the crowd before you? Or the enemy who wants to harm the people you are protecting? So those are the things we need to think about. Now something else that we need to know.
Ntabwo nta na hamwe tubona yigeze ihana umusirikare warashe ku rugamba ikavuga ngo wakoze icyaha cyo kwica.
In the Bible we don't see even a single soldier being punished because of shooting when fighting.
Ayo maraso yamenekeye ku rugamba barwanya umwanzi.
It's because that blood that was shed in a battle as they fought against the enemy.
kumena maraso atari hurubanza.
So it does not, it is not part of what the Bible talks about.
Ayo ya meneke ye
kurugamba. So the blood which was shed in a battle.
Nabugari innocent blood.
It is not an innocent blood.
Nabugara maraso atari hurubanza.
It is not an innocent
blood. Ahubwo na maraso yarari hurubanza.
But actually it is a blood that is.
Cho ni byiza ko tucyumva kandi tukagisobanukirwa.
So it is important for us to understand this.
So zamvuga iki rero.
So as I come to the end, I want to say this.
Kimwe n'indi mihamagaro yose,
like any other callings,
umuntu ujya mu gisirikare,
a person who joins the army,
akeneye kubanza akamenya igisirikare agiye marikiye.
He needs to know the type of army that he's
kirarwanirira iki,
and what are they fighting for?
Ese gifite impamvu zo kurwana?
Do they have a reason to fight?
Abivuga gutya hagahita uvuga ati buriya ugiye no muri FDLR nta kibazo.
So otherwise you may say if you join even FDLR it's okay. That's a big issue.
Ukeneye kujya mu gisirikare wabajije Imana ukavuga ngo iki gisirikare gifite icyerekezo.
If you want to join an army you need to inquire from God and be sure that they have a like an other calling.
Ntabwo nubwo wahamagarirwa kuba umupastoro upfa kuba umupastoro witorera ubonye.
Even though you are called to be a pastor you don't become a pastor of any church.
Ntabwo nubwo wahamagarirwa kuba umu businessman uzaba uzakora business yose ubonye.
So if you are called to do a business you cannot sell anything.
Ibyo Imana iguhamagarira kandi bifite icyerekezo kijya mu cyerekezo Imana iri kukwereka.
So you need to do things that God is calling you for and according to his direction.
Ariko nubwo mvuze ibyo byose.
So even though I have said all these things.
Nubwo uri mu gisirikare.
Even though you are part of the army.
Uracyafite inshingano yo kurengera inzira karengana.
You still have a responsibility to protect the victims.
Igihe ubonye igisirikare urimo kiri kugira abo kirenganya.
So when you realize that your army is treating some people unfairly.
Icyo gihe ya maraso noneho hagiye kumenwa yafite urubanza.
Now that blood that is going to be shed there will be a judgment.
Ukeneye kurengera inzira karengana.
So you need to protect the victims.
Urugero rworoshye ni umugabo muri iminsi witwa umurinzi w'igihango.
Is a person who is called
the guardian of
the guardian of the covenant.
The covenant, yes.
The guardian of the covenant.
Umugabo witwa Silas wahoze ari mu ngabo za kera zakoze genocide.
Who is part of the former army that did
yarengeye abantu aho yari mu gisirikare gako.
So he protected people where he was at
Gako. Uyu munsi igihugu kimuha gaciro.
So today he's honored by the nation.
Nubwo yari umusirikare.
Even though he was a soldier.
Yarabizi ko abatutsi bicwaga ntabwo aribo bahanganye nabo ku rugamba.
So he knew that Tutsis that were being killed are not the one they fought.
Yarengeye abarenga 20 bose abambutse abagera i Burundi.
So he rescued around 20
kugera
people.
Ubwo nawe yendaga kwasiga ubuzima nawe ahungira i Burundi.
Actually when he was about to be killed he also fled to Burundi.
Kandi cyabimuteye ntimugire ngo ni ikindi.
And don't think there is no other motive. It's because he
nuko
is a
Imana,
he knew God.
Ndagira ngo nakire Papa Musoni nkumwe
yanabivuze
muri teori.
Papa Musoni
abwire muri practice.
Saying this as theory, but I want him to give you the practical example.
Ntabwo ndibwihe kuvuga amarangi ye.
I'm not going to mention his ranks.
Arabibibwirira ariko
going to mention this.
Ibi bintu byaba ari ukuri cyangwa mbeshya abantu.
Is it true or am I lying?
Because now go beshya.
Thank you. You are saying the truth.
Kare nabwo ngiye kuvuga marangi yanje.
And I'm not going to mention my ranks.
Ahubwo icyo ngiye guhamenya
n'icyo
Papa Rambera amaze kuvuga mu buryo bw'ijambo ry'Imana.
Is what Papa Rambera has just said in the word of God.
Kugira ngo ngihamye nange nk'umuntu wakibayemo.
Now for me to testify it as a person who has been part of the army.
Nabwo mfata umwanya munini ndafata iminota 5 gusa.
I'll just to take around 5 minutes.
Kubera ko ikibazo kirimo kibazwa no kwibaza ngo se ishobora kuba umusirikare nkaba n'umukristo.
So the question here is can I be a Christian and a soldier at the same time?
Ese ntabwo habana gushobora kubaho?
Are there no conflict of interest?
Nagira ngo mpamye yuko bidahabanye.
I want to confirm that there is no conflict of interest.
Umurimo w'Imana no muhamagaro w'Imana.
So it is a calling of God.
N'igisirikare no murimo w'Imana.
And also the army being part of the army is a calling of God.
Murimo murakubita amashyi makeya nyamara murabizi namwe murabibona.
And you know this and you can see it.
Umurimo w'igisirikare no murimo w'Imana.
Now serving in the army it is God's calling.
Nkuko yabivuze umuntu akwiye kwibaza ese kubera iki abaturage b'igihugu bose badafatwa ngo bagirwe abasirikare. Abasirikare bakaba ari abantu bakeya mu baturage b'igihugu.
You may ask yourself how comes the entire population is not enrolled into the army, only some people are selected to be part of the army.
Ya handi Imana ivuga ngo nashatse umuntu umwe uhagarara mu cyuho kugira ngo ahuze ubwoko bw'Imana n'Imana kugira ngo barakari bw'Imana batagera kubana b'Imana yashatse umuntu umwe yashatse bakeya n'abakozi b'Imana Imana yishakiye kugira ngo bahagarare mu cyo cyo kurinda abandi basigaye.
So these are a few people that God selected to stand in the gap to protect others who are remaining.
Numuri mukomeye rero cyane kandi numuri w'Imana ngira ngo mujya mubibona.
So it is an important surfaces and that also God cares about and you are able to see this.
Iyo mubona buri gihe abasirikare bahagaze ku muhanda umunsi wose kuva mu gitondo kugera nimugoroba.
You see some soldiers standing on the streets from morning to evening.
Sinzi niba umurimo bakora wo kurinda abaturage ugeneye umu umushahara wa ubona.
I don't know if you would attach a wage to what they do, you'll be able to find enough money.
Niyo mpamvu ijambo ry'Imana yavuze muri Luka.
And that is why the word of God he mentioned.
Yesu yabwiye abasirikare ngo ikintu cya mbere mukwiye kumenya mugomba kwishimira ibihembo byanyu.
So the first thing Jesus told the soldiers is to be content with their wages.
Kubiko ibihembo byanyu ni giye ubibaha kuko nta muntu wabibona kuko birarenze ntabwo mushobora nta wabibona.
It is God who rewards the soldiers. Nations cannot have enough money to compensate them.
Icyo rero ngena ashaka kuvuga nagira ngo mbabwire jyewe.
So I wanted to tell you that I personally
nange nakoze umwuga wa gisirikare.
I served in the army.
Nakoze umwuga wa gisirikare mu gihe cy'imyaka 23.
For 23 years.
Muri iyo myaka.
Now in those 23. In those 23 years.
15.
15 years among them.
Nayi maze ndu musirikare ndi numukozi w'Imana.
I was a soldier and a servant of God.
Icyo gihe cyose namaze ndu musirikare ndi umukozi w'Imana ndi umukristo.
Now during that period when I was at the same time a Christian and a soldier.
Nta kibazo nigeze ngirana n'abayobozi banjye.
I did not have an issue with my superiors.
Narasengaga nakora umurimo w'Imana.
I prayed and did the ministry of God.
Nakora n'umurimo wa gisirikare nkuko umurimo binsaba.
And at the same time serving in the army as I was requested to.
Nta incompatibility nta kudahuza na hamwe nigeze mbona mu murimo wanjye.
So I did not find any conflict of interest in my ministry.
Umurimo w'Imana ntabwo ari umurimo ni nakoze mpisha.
So and when I was doing serving God, I did not do it hiding myself.
Umurimo nakoraga abayobozi banjye babizi neza yuko ngukora.
I did it openly and even my superiors knew it.
Ni ukuvuga ngo uko nari ndi hano mu rusengero uko mwambonaga abakristo bambonaga niko n'abayobozi banjye bagisirikare babonaga yuko ndi umukristo nkaba n'umusirikare.
So the same way you would see me as a servant of God, the same way my superiors would see me being a soldier.
Ibi mushobora kwibaza mukavuga muti se byashobokaga bite.
Now you may ask yourself, how was it possible?
Kuko harabibaza bakavuga bati ese waba umusirikare ukaba n'umukristo ntabwo bihura ntibishoboka.
Because some people wonder whether there's no conflict of interest being a soldier and a Christian.
Ibyo abantu bibaza haraho bishoboka.
So that question it is possible in some instances.
Iyo wabyitwayemo nabi.
If you do not conduct yourself properly.
Iyo wabikoze uko bitagomba gukorwa.
When you do it in the wrong way.
Ijambo ry'Imana riratubwira mu mubwiriza.
So the word of God tells us in Ecclesiastes.
Ngo buri kintu kigira umwanya wacyo.
Everything has its own time.
Iyo ugiye rero kubivanga ugakora ikintu kitari cyo mu mwanya wacyo.
Now when you mix the two and do things in the wrong time.
Ni koko biragongana.
So now there is a conflict of interest.
Ariko icyo nababwira nk'umuntu wabibayemo.
But what I can tell you as a person who has practical experience.
Nuko umurimo w'Imana.
The ministry of God.
Gusenga Imana.
Praying to God.
Ubukristo.
Christianity.
N'igisirikare.
And army.
Ni bimwe naho bitaniye.
It is the same.
Aho bitaniye nuko kimwe gikorwa mu mubiri ikindi kigakorwa mu mwuka.
The difference is that one thing is done in physically and the other part is done in the spiritual realm.
Ibyo dukora hano mu rusengero.
So what we do here in the church.
N'igisirikare.
It is the army.
Muzanyure muri Bibiliya murebe uko Imana yagibana n'abantu bayo.
So if you go through the Bible looking at how God related with his people, it is an army.
Ariko ni igisirikare mu buryo bwo mu mwuka.
But it is an army in the spiritual realm.
Icyo mubona rero cyiza kigafatika mu buryo bufatika.
Now what is visible and tangible?
Iyo gikozwe gisohotse mu mwuka.
When it is done being when it comes from the spirit,
gikorwa neza.
It is done in a good way.
Kandi ntagira ikigongana n'ikindi.
And there are no conflicts of interest.
Ndashimira Imana rero.
So I'm thankful to God.
Iyo myaka yose namaze mu gisirikare.
For all those years that I spent in the army.
Nari mwe igisirikare kigeze kimbangamira mu murimo w'Imana.
At no single point the army became difficult for me. Kugeza
nyuma y'icyo gihe cy'imyaka 23.
After all those 23 years that I mentioned.
Nasezerewe mu cyubahiro.
So now I was released. And they thanked me because of the good work that I did. And I'm convinced that even in heaven they thank me for the good work that I've done. So without further ado, this is the testimony that I wanted to give you, so that you don't just hear it from a theoretical perspective, but to see that it is also possible practically. Something else that I can add, I'm speaking personally, but I can be a witness of many others who also served in the army and who are still doing it, and who are still also serving in the house of God without compromising trust, because God gives them wisdom to do everything at the right time. May the Lord Jesus bless you. And even the reason why you are even seated here, it's because of the fellows of Elder Musoni. The reason why our pastor came back to this nation, and even Lambert came from
Tingitingi,
it's because of the work of the army. So the reason why we are praying in peace, it's because of the army. So that is why I want us to pray for those who are serving in the army. So please, if you can stand up so that you can pray.
Mwami Yesu, mu izina ryawe turagushimiye ko waduhaye abantu bitangira kuba muri uyu murimo w'igisirikare. Turagushimira abasavinzi mu bihe byashize uyu munsi batakikirimo. Turagushimira abari gusavinga muri iki gihe. Turagushimira ibikorwa bakoze bitumye u Rwanda rugera aho rugeze uyu munsi. Mwami, rekaho kubabona nk'abantu bari aho ngaho gusa, tubashyigikire, tubasengere, duhagararane nabo mu mwuka. Kandi uwo muri twebwe Imana yahamagara, yemera uwo muhamagaro kugira ngo agenda ukore neza. Dusabiye sisteme y'igisirikare cyacu hano mu Rwanda, dusabiye sisteme y'igisirikare muri Afrika, dusaba ngo iby'ijambo ryawe ryatubwiye. Kutagira uwo batwaza igitugu, kutagira kuba baba kwishyira hejuru ntibanyurwe n'ibyo bahabwa. Mwami Imana ubivaneho, ariko utanga umugisha wawe kuri buri wese. Utanga umugisha wawe kuri buri wese. Uwakoze n'ukiri gukora ndetse n'uzakora ejo hazaza. Urakoze rero kuri Imana, urakoze kuri byose. Ukomeze kubana natwe mu gihe gisigaye cyose kiri iteraniro. Mu izina rya Yesu tubisabye twizeye.
Amen. We pray and believe in the name of Jesus. Amen.